Hi everybody, this is Dr. A. In this fourth video on quality, we're going to talk about proficiency testing. So this video is probably going to be a little bit shorter. So proficiency testing is a means by which quality control between laboratories is maintained. So participation in a proficiency testing program involves receiving identical specimens, samples periodically. And so the agency, usually CAP that does it, sends specimens out to multiple labs, and then the results will send back to the entity, to CAP, that has sent them out, and they grade everybody based on their performance. So the results of the assays are graded for each participating lab according to designated evaluation limits, and the results are compared with those of other laboratories that are participating in the same PT program. And so that allows you to see not only if you have an unknown, can you get the results right, but two, how are you faring compared to other laboratories. This is required by CAP, the College of American Pathologists, and they're one of the accreditating agencies in the U.S. for labs. It is required by CLIA, and pretty much everybody that gets federal dollars falls into CLIA. And it is also required by the Joint Commission to maintain lab accreditation. So most clinical labs use proficiency testing programs provided by CAP, the College of American Pathologists. So let's talk a little bit about the CLIA requirements. So the CLIA regulations will apply to FDA and non-FDA cleared tests. And so FDA cleared are the wave testing, and then the non-FDA cleared are the moderate complexity and high complexity assays. If a lab performs moderate complexity, high complexity tests for which there is no proficiency testing, then it must have a system for verifying the accuracy and reliability of its test results at least twice a year. If a laboratory performs only wave tests, it is not required to participate in a proficiency testing program. So per CLIA 88, a lab must establish and follow written QC procedures for monitoring and evaluating the quality of the analytical testing process for each method to ensure the accuracy and reliability of the patient results and reports. The timing of the PT testing for most entities are going to be at least three times a year, about every once a quarter. They send these surveys, CAP surveys out is what they call them. So what is the testing process? So you get a series of unknown samples is sent to the lab from the program, so usually from CAP. The samples are analyzed in the same manner as a patient specimen, so they need to be put into the normal run of things, and they need to be done by the person that is doing the test. So if a CAP survey comes in and you're the person assigned to chemistry and it's a chemistry CAP survey, then you're doing it. It's not up to the lead tech in chemistry to do it. It has to be done by the testing personnel. The results are then reported to the program and compiled with results from all the other labs that participate in the survey, and then a performance report is sent back to each participating lab. Now, one of the implications of this is if the lab gets the results wrong, okay? So they must investigate first what happened. Maybe they were having some control problems. Maybe there was some analytical problems. They have to investigate and report back. Now, again, this happens several times a year. On the next survey, so a few months later, the next survey comes in for the same assay. If the lab passes, then all's good. If the lab fails it, and fails it three times in a row, that lab can completely lose the ability to bill for that test and therefore to perform that test. And so that would be a loss of revenue, a loss of service to the patients. But if they can't get it right three times in a row, then they don't need to be doing that test. They need to find out there's a problem with the lab. They need to find out what's going on in their testing process, why this is messing up. So lab must incorporate the proficiency testing into its routine workflow as much as possible. Again, it has to be like a patient sample. It can't be treated special. The test value samples cannot be shared with other labs at any time during the testing cycle, so you cannot send them to your friends in the lab across town to see what they're getting and then to make sure that your stuff's right. Proficiency samples are tested by the bench tech, who normally does patient testing, and the testing should be completed within its usual time. So you don't sit on it for a while. There's a certain window you got to get it in, and you know, whoever's assigned when the survey comes in is usually who gets to do it. There are some alternatives to proficiency testing. So if a proficiency testing program is not available for a specific analyte, then an alternate assessment of quality is needed. There are several methods that exist. It could be an external split sample. So participate with another laboratory using the same method or another method, but they're testing the same sample. Take the sample, split it, and see what everybody gets, right? An internal split sample, so re-examine a specific patient sample by a different method or perform by a different tech to see if you get the same results. An audit sample, so analyze the same sample over time to assess the reproducibility and stability of a method. And the use of government or university interlaboratory comparisons is also an option. So, for example, when all the COVID testing hit the market and labs had to deal with it, it was because everything happened so fast, there was not CAP surveys, I'm sure, in place at the beginning. And so, an alternate way to make sure that the test was being done proficiently had to be used, I'm sure, for the labs that were doing it. So. All right, so that wraps up proficiency testing, and there'll be more videos to come on quality. So thank you for your attention.